But here's your options. The pad is $79.99. A pad like this one, which is a professional Gibraltar pad, when I bought mine, cost me $60. And that's the pad you guys have seen me use in numerous videos before I had all this other stuff, okay? So you get a $60 pad. If you can find it cheaper than that, I'm happy for you. Some people can find it for $40 or whatever, but usually it retails for $60. Guitar Center had it marked a retail list price at $90 and was selling it for $60 on sale. So for $60, you can just have a pad all by itself, or for the $79.99, you can have a pad that has functionality that's ready to go out the box to work with Guitar Hero World Tour, and you never have to use Guitar Hero World Tour pedal again. I understand that a lot of people love the Guitar Hero World Tour pedal. It is a vast improvement over some other pedals, but there's nothing like playing with a real pedal. So you can get the pad by itself that works with any pedal. So if you have a pedal already, or you like me, you've got to be a DW5000, you got a Pearl, you got a Yamaha, you got a Twin Turbo, which is by Cobra, any of those pedals, you just hook onto the Destroyer pad, Destroyer Pro D, and it's ready to go. Don't have to buy anything else, $79.99. But if you need the combo, you can buy the Destroyer Pro D and the Gibraltar pedal that I've showed you, which is right here. You can buy both of those for the price of $129.99, okay? Once again, a pad is going to cost you $60 with nothing in it. A decent pedal is going to range from between $30 to anywhere into the hundreds, okay? Depending on what your taste is. Me, I have to have smoothness and a whole bunch of other stuff, so my pedals, none of my pedals that I own cost me up underneath $100. So you're going to get a top-of-the-line pedal ready to go out of the box, $129.99, get you the Destroyer Pro D and the Gibraltar. But let's say you're a huge fan of the Destroyer pedal, you like how the Destroyer pedal feels, and you want a standalone pedal for that. We got you covered with that one, because you can buy the Destroyer Pro D and the Dixon 711 pedal, which is what the Destroyer is made out of, for $114.99. The Destroyer pedal all by itself costs you $75. For $114, you can have the Destroyer Pro D and you can have the Dixon 711 pedal, and you're ready to go. So who is this most suited for? I'm going to say this is most suited for everybody. I realize that Guitar Hero World Tour has not had a huge problem right now with their pedals. Maybe it's the only thing, because like I said, everybody says I hate on Activision. No, I showed you guys. My red pad has not worked since the first day. I took it out of the box, I set it up, and I did like this. And that was it, and the pad stopped working, okay? So I don't have a lot of faith in the first generation Guitar Hero World Tour stuff right now. So this is going to cancel that out. Let me point this out. You're going to be able to do double bass on this. You're going to already beat the curve. From what I've been reading and what I've been hearing, when Guitar Hero Metallica comes out, they're going to sell you an add-on to do double bass. I don't know how much that's going to cost, but if you already own a double bass pedal, you can go pick up a double bass pedal decently if you look around for between $50 to $119. The Destroyer Pro D is already going to handle that. You just hook the pedal up, and the Surface is going to take both of those. Nothing else you got to do, okay? So you already beat the curve on that. You're going to save yourself some money because you have the Destroyer Pro D right now. And if you already have a double bass pedal, you're ready to go. Guitar Hero Metallica is supposed to be one of the hardest drum games that's coming out. So I'm not really sure how much or how long that pedal that you guys have is going to hold up. Remember, some of the hardest tunes in Rock Band 1 was Metallica. Most people, a lot of people broke their pedal on Injustice for All. We got a whole ton of nothing but Metallica songs and Metallica and Guitar Hero Metallica, so you guys do the math, all right? If you're looking for a solution that has a real piazza in it and you want to not spend that much money, you need to go with the Destroyer Pro D. Here's why. It costs at least $129 to $150 for you to get into a Roland KD8, which is what I use most of the time. But I already had mine when I paid the higher price for it, okay? So you can pay $150 for it, and plus if you're starting out brand new, you still have no pedal. So even with the shipping and handling, by the time you get the KD8, by the time you get a pedal that's decent to work with it, you're already over the price of the Pro D. So I recommend you guys get the Pro D for that, all right? Like I said, it has no drop notes. I showed you guys that on Pull Me Under. All the double bass notes, all the notes that I mentioned on my own. As you look further on the video, you see that I did hit a whole bunch of those. But it's only my second time playing that song. And as much as I love the song is not the world's easiest song to play on drums. But I wanted to show you guys that. I didn't want to come out and play like on the road again. And, you know, anybody can go. I mean, you know, you're not going to drop a note. But when you're playing the hard stuff, you're going to drop notes. All right? So let's go to the prices one more time. The Destroyer Pro D pad only is going to cost you $79.99. The Destroyer Pro D with the Gibraltar Prowler pedal together is going to cost you $129.99. And the Destroyer Pro D with the Dixon 711, which is the exact same pedal that you have if you own the Destroyer pedal, is going to cost you $114.99. Now, Mark has decided that he's selling his products also on rockbandparts.com. He has also decided that he is going to bring out the Destroyer Pro D and the whole line of it exclusively for the next week, starting from this watching of this video, only on rockbandparts.com. Let me tell you what you guys get, because this is the last part that I can't forget to cover. What are you guys looking at for manufacturer's warranties? I have to stress this and stress this hard. The only Destroyer product that carries a full lifetime warranty on it is the Destroyer Classic. That's it. Okay. So there's a lot of people that wrote me and said, well, all these products are going to have lifetime products. I have to clear it up. All his products will not carry a lifetime warranty. The Destroyer Classic is the only one so far in this line that will carry a lifetime warranty. The Destroyer Pro D, along, no matter which one you buy, either the Destroyer Pro D pad by itself or with either pedal, is only going to carry a 90-day warranty on that. Rockman Parts is going to give you a 5-year warranty, hands down. So if you buy from rockbandparts.com, you can only get it there anyway for the next week. This is what Marcus decided. You're going to get a 5-year warranty on that, and that's going to cover, we say, all the moving parts. So let me just kind of cover what that means a little bit, because the owner, you know, talked to me and I talked to him about exactly what the warranty means. Moving parts, yes, the sensors is covered. If your pedal breaks or something happens to it like that, yes, it's all covered. If you take it and throw it out of a window, you let your dog chew on it, you take a sledgehammer and you beat it to death, you take a blowtorch, obviously that's not covered. But that has to be said, because people will try this stuff and say they didn't honor the warranty, okay? One thing I want to clip at rockbandparts.com real quick is, it is not my website. I do not own it. I am just a partner to it, as far as I thought it was a very good concept. It's a one-stop shop for all of my people who watch these reviews. And I'd rather send you guys one place where you can watch everything and get everything, and there it is, all right? So, exclusive only, rockbandparts.com, the Destroyer Pro D. This is also part of the rockbandparts.com grand opening, and this is why Mark is choosing to do this. So if you go skate around, you're going to find this great deal and probably find a whole ton more that's out there, because I heard prices got slashed. So I've been so busy, I haven't got a chance to take a look at it. Okay, so that's the review on the Destroyer Pro D. I'm very excited about it. I use it a whole ton of time. I've been using it a lot more than my Roland KD8, to be honest, because it's been easier. It's all hooked in, jacked in, ready to go. No drop notes. If you want to answer for your Guitar Hero World Tour pedal, here it is. If you already own a Kickbox, you can plug that in and it's going to work with Rock Band. If you don't, you can get one of those or any other interface that you have that's going to make this work with Rock Band 1 and Rock Band 2, and you're good to go. All right, so look for more products coming out from the Destroyer pedal line of things. Mark is not done yet. He is just beginning. This is just one of the things he wanted to get out to all of his people that play Guitar Hero World Tour. I'm very proud to be the first one to bring you the first third-party app for Guitar Hero World Tour to show you guys I do have mad love for the game. There's just not a lot of stuff out there. So hopefully now that's changing. So keep your eye on Mark. There's still other things he's coming out with. And as soon as they get released and I hear about it, you guys will know. All right, so That's it. Hope you guys enjoyed this review. And until next time, saying peace, love, keep rocking out. And we're going to catch you guys on the next review.
Around. Ayo, ayo, ayo. Let me see you.